I was embarrassed, I was ashamed, and I always felt we were the poor kids, you know, in the neighborhood with the way that I dressed and never had money to do the things, you know, that I wanted to do, like my friend Mark, who lived in the wealthy neighborhood. It was a kid that I met at the local community center right across the street from my home. And Mark would invite me to his home for dinners on a infrequent basis, and I loved the way that his parents communicated, and I loved, you know, the trips that he took with his family, and I loved that he was always able to keep up with, you know, the nicest clothes, and he had a lot of the nice things that my family just couldn't afford. My mother worked really hard working at a local department store. My father worked really hard as a cab driver. He still has the same mindset, you know, that he had, you know, 45 years ago when I was a young man. 12 years old, whatever the case might be. He still has the same, you know, discussions around money and how much this stuff costs and how much it's gonna cost for the light to be on in the house if you're not in the room to turn off the light. You know, he still has the scarcity mentality that there's not enough. I was fortunate that at the age of 19, I met a man that really took everything that I shared with him about my past, and he asked me some questions that nobody ever asked me before. He says, have you ever thought about the fact that you're recreating that story over and over and over again, and you've bought into that story that because of your past, because of your parents, because of the other kids, you want this, and because of the way you were raised, you didn't want that. He says, have you ever thought that that could be your story to freedom? I said, what do you mean that could be my story to freedom? He says, why don't you take personal responsibility for using the story, using your past, as something you don't want for yourself anymore, but become the young man, become the person that it takes to upgrade your knowledge and skills and habits and behaviors and expectations so that you don't keep recreating your parents' story, your friends' story. So write your own story and then create that. And he shifted my thinking, shifted my frame from being a victim of my parents, being a victim of my school or my education, to becoming victorious by controlling what I focused on and the story that I was going to create. So I'd write down a script for health and wealth and relationships and career and business and fun and experiences and charity, and I'd write down a story almost like a Hollywood writer would write down a story that they'd be filming, you know, with Hollywood actors. Looked at the sheet of paper of what I was looking to attract, and you look at the side of who I needed to become, there's almost a perfect match between what I wrote down and who I became. But it all started off with taking responsibility, no blame, no shame, no guilt, no justification, no embarrassment, taking responsibility for my piece of this and getting clear on exactly what I wanted to achieve, because I didn't want to recreate that story. I became something different.